dYdX lets you open up loans. So you put some ETH as a collateral, and then you take out a loan, and then you do margin trading. And so sometimes your ETH collateral drops below a certain value, and that means your loan is not liquid. So what they have is they have some bots that go in and liquidate these loans, essentially sell a portion of your collateral at a 5% discount to make sure your loan is again at the right level. So the spread here, the 5%, is the bonus to these bots or these people. Anyone can go in and liquidate. So this company is doing this liquidation analysis, and they wanted the data. So what we did is we just built a liquidation model for them. So you can see count, broken down by month. Let's see the profit, then the gas spent, and ETH transaction. So what we have, we can actually do it by collateral type and borrow type. So this one row here, 7/2019, which would be July, for the wrapped ether to DAI market, there were 630 liquidations of the loans. And the total profit was $200,000. That's a lot of money. Just the profit. Of course, the dollar amounts are also available here. But just the profit, the spread, was $200,000. And something that's very interesting here is that transaction costs are like crazy, because everyone is, all these bots are actually racing each other. So if you look at the actual transaction, they're 10 times there. Sometimes some of these transactions are $100, $200 transaction fee, because they want that, you know, that 5% spread. So this is an example. So you can see, like, I think in September 25, 26, there was actually a big crash of ETH. So a lot of loans got liquidated. So you can see, yeah, there, $300,000 in their wrapped ether to DAI. That's the profit. So we have these liquidation models for different collateralized loan platforms, dYdX, Compound, BZX. And so what these guys are using is essentially their, you can just download the CSE, or you can create an API endpoint and put it in your Excel spreadsheet. So it's always fresh data. Excel and Google Docs has this feature called import data. So on Google Docs, you can say equal to import data, and then this URL. And what happens is all of your data is always fresh in your Google Sheet. So you can just create whatever formulas you want, and it's always updated. You don't have to download the CSV each time. Excel has that data query capability as well.
Can you explain why the numbers, if you go below, were negative in terms of profits?
Yeah, so this is rounding error. So what we have is our price data is granular on a day level, and this is only $76. So it's not, it's all rounding errors. Like this is $50, this is like $3. Okay. So even like the 5% spread plus or minus, it's like,
there were very small orders then.
Yeah, it's only like two liquidations for the DAI USDC. Because the stablecoin, you know, what is the, it's never going to change, right? It's never volatile, right? You use a stablecoin as a collateral and take out a stablecoin as a loan. It's not really, yeah, that's why it doesn't.
Do you have the same for Compound? I mean, MakerDAO?
We don't have a model for MakerDAO, but, you know, it's something on R2 do. Okay. But if that's of interest to you, you know, we can collaborate on a MakerDAO compound, on a model. These models are all less than, you know, 100, 150 lines. It's just a very simple JSON file. And
all of this data comes from the Ethereum blockchain.
Yes. This is the, it's all of this data is on the
Ethereum. Everything is available there.
Everything is available there. So the only thing that's not available are the prices. So we actually have a volume weighted price index for all historical prices. And because this is for mostly for historical analysis rather than real time usage of data, so far daily granularity of the prices has been enough. But if you want, you know, the exact spot price at that time, there are other providers we're willing to work with. Like Nomix has that real time order book prices, so you can definitely tap into that. But once you have the balance, then you can just multiply that with whatever that price is, right? You can do a VLOOKUP. So that can be done outside the platform.
So like the profits in dollars are measured through your volume weighted price average for the day.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. So the...
And that's why you get these numbers that are negative also, because it's exactly. not exactly the right price.
But so it's always done in two steps. We do all of the calculations using data on the blockchain. And then for display purposes, we multiply it with the daily volume weighted prices to just show the user. But under this thing, there's actually a column here. So like transaction cost ETH, for example, there's no variance in this because that's exactly on the blockchain. But then the value of ETH would change depending on the source that you multiply with.
And like for these prices, where do you get them from?
We have crawlers for that.
Okay.
So yeah, that's one example, and